Hi, this is Tom Does Tech. I'm Tom, and in this video, we're going to look at validating your Express REST APIs with Yup. So I'm going to assume that you're already familiar with Yup or willing to learn Yup. It's quite easy to get your head around. So if we have a look at this user's create user endpoint, it adds a payload to the user's array, and the payload has a name, email, age, and website. So if we hit that endpoint with this body, we can see that it will add the body to the user's array and we get that back. But the problem is that we can't know what these values are. So if we say age is a string, so if we say age is a string of 30, then it will accept the input. But that's obviously not correct. So we're going to do this with Express middleware. So we'll create a new folder for middleware. And in that middleware, we'll create a file called validate request. And we'll import object from Yup. And we'll create a function called validate and export that function as default. And we'll get the validate request is going to be Express middleware. So it's going to have a request, a response, and a next function. We can get the interfaces for these from Express. So our function's also going to take a schema when it's first initialized. So that's going to be schema, which is of type any schema. And we'll change this to a const. So we want to call validate on the schema. So we can say await schema.validate. And this function needs to be async. And we can pass in our body as request.body. And we also want to be able to validate query and params. And then we'll call next. And then we need to wrap this in a try catch because validate will throw an error if it comes across a validation error. And we'll catch that error. And we will return rec.status 400.send. Okay, so we have our validation middleware ready to use. We just need to use it in our endpoint. So if we come back to our routes, we can import validate from middleware / validate request. And we can pass it in the middleware section of our route. And now we just need to create our schema. So create a new folder called DTO and a new file called create user.schema.ts. We'll import object from Yup. And we don't need to import that in this file. And if we come back to our user controller, we can have a look at the interface that we need. Paste that down here, and we can recreate this interface in Yup. So we'll say export default object requires a name, email, age, and website. So this will be a string, and that is required. Same with email, website. And we need to also import number for age. And our email is going to be string.email. And we can put a custom error message in there if they put in an invalid email. So we say must be a valid email. And website is going to be string.url. And we'll say that this must be a valid URL. And then we can put in our required message as well. So we can say name is required, age is required. So the last thing to do is to import this schema and pass this into our validate function. So if we come back over to Postman and we try to send this request again with age as a string, we can see we get a error, website is required, which is not what we'd expect. Age must be a number. So the problem is that we have in our validate request said that we expect a body, but in here we've put this at the root of the object. So we need to move this down to body, which is going to be another object, and we can put our schema in here. So if we try to put in something that isn't a number into age, we see it body.age must be type of number. And so if we fix that again and we put a invalid URL in website, you can see that we get must be a valid URL. So that is how to validate your REST API with Yup. Thank you for watching. Please like the video and subscribe.